know, to some children, daddy is like a superman. That's why the father is so important to the home, because children really look up to their father. Here's this little boy boasting about his father. My daddy is the best daddy. My daddy is the best daddy. My daddy have a car. It's the fastest car in the whole world. My daddy car fast. And see my daddy strong. My daddy just lift weight. Ask mommy if you think I lie. My daddy strong. Once when my daddy was a boy, he had a bicycle. Was the fastest bicycle in the whole world. The handlebar bend. And when you see my daddy coming down the road with speed for so you know, my daddy was no joke rider. Once my daddy bumps a woman, she had a bucket of milk on her head. She spin up in the air 3 times and she land on her foot. Not one drop of milk fall. Yes, my daddy knows the bumps people. Good. Yes, my daddy's the best daddy. Plenty of people owe my daddy money. But my daddy see is all right. God good, they will pay him one day. My daddy and God is get on. Good. Yes, my daddy is the best daddy. And my daddy popular. Now you know, when my daddy passing, everybody calling him Temsky's daddy. My daddy popular. Yes, my daddy is the best daddy. My daddy is the best daddy. What about your daddy? You know, sometimes they say that the best cricket is played off the field. I mean, any given time after a test match, you could pass outside any place in town and you hear people talking, and you could swear it's some of the best cricketers talking inside there. This is what I heard once, a fella talking. Bring on the fastest man you got. I declare in war today. Bring on all your spinners. I treating them same way. My cap pulled down, my collar up, my pads they buckle tight. I playing for West Indies. It's fight, I come to fight. I playing every stroke they got, the drive, the cut, the hook, and even some you wouldn't find in any cricket book. You could put 10 men to field in slips, that don't bother me. And if I was you, I'll put 10 more on every damn boundary. Because when you see I start to hit, it's only 4 and 6. No matter what the ball you bowl, this batsman's sharing licks. I make them Indian bowlers cry, Australia, that was fat. And the blues we put on England, they ain't recover yet. My cap pulled down, my collar up, my pads they buckle tight. I playing for West Indies, it's fight I come to fight. Here now, I play each ball on merit. I don't lose my cool. I don't throw away my wicket. Me ain't nobody fool. Because when you see I cover up, not a bowler getting through. So it's pointless bowling umpire, it's LBW. Short ball, bouncer, googly, all the same to me. I read them bowlers like a book and blade them equally. And when I catch them slacking off, man, I treat them with disdain, crack right through the covers. If you put your hand, it's pain. I mean, you have to be brave to stop my ball because I give it all I got. So when you see it coming, boy, you know it's coming hot. My cap pulled down, my collar up, my pants is buckled tight. I playing for West Indies. It's fight I come to fight. You know, man. I playing cricket for my small. Win ball, 6 aside. With broomstick handled in the street. When police come, we hide. We never used to wear no shoes, wearing pads. Man, that was a joke. And my foot still have the marks from where I missed my strokes. And when was cricket on the beach, was coconut branch for bat. And the stumps was some old sweet drink case. Was cricket, I could tell you that. Boys bowl left, girls bat right. The umpire was in the sea. And as far as I could recall, that's where cricket start for me. Yeah man, my cap pulled down, my collar up, my pads they buckle tight. I playing for West Indies. It's fight I come to fight. Hey now man, big man they start to tremble when I walk towards the crease. See them rearrange the field like trying to catch some teeth. But my fans just chant and carry on every time I make a stand. And every time I play the ball in, that is mine. Umpires all respect me and my integrity. I know the game, I read the rules, they can't put one on me. And if by chance, some lucky fluke, they get me out some way. I mean, the grace with I leave a field, man, is like I know come out to play. The umpire word is final, I shout it loud and clear. And I walk to the pavilion, man, my head up in the air. The cap pulled down, my collar up, my pants, they buckle tight. I playing for West Indies. It's fight, I come to fight. All you only laughing when you hear me talk. Well, one day I go prove to all you that this ain't no skylark. I love my game of cricket, boy. That is my pride and joy. In any case, I could say anything I want, because me, I'm only the water boy. When we reach the oval now, she pulled out a parasol. And not only an ordinary parasol, but a pink parasol. Now tell me what I do in the oval with a pink parasol. It's not even carnival. And she opened it and tried to go to the oval gate. She said nobody could kill she with sunstroke. Well, you know the oval gate already. Them man don't have no time to look at nobody. It's a handy money the ticket. They handy money the ticket. But they had to look at Aunt Imol because she nearly juke out the eye. And here the man go turn and tell me, if your wife afraid son, why you leave she home? No, you say aunt, you say grandmother, he say wife. Say no, I feel it. Then who are bunks up there first? Boysy and the boys. Well, who send me? If you hear them, howdy madam, where get a woman from, boy? You can't introduce the boys. Make sure she have a good will, you know, like she look like she go dead any minute. And they start to heckle me. But thank God, cricket so hot. The day they have no time to be. Because Ireland's batting, Trinidad bowling. Trinidad are wicked to take, Ireland's a run to make. So I settled down to enjoy the match. And it's then Tanti Moore start up. She watched a fella in front of her and she said, take off your hat. She said, Barry now. Well, you know what happened next was a real ignorant fella she interfered with. Well, he started to call she and she started to call she and I trying to put peace. Thank God just then Richard's out. Because Richard out the crease. The bowler running up, spot him, hit the wicket. Umpire say, Richard's out. Well, who tell he say that? Tanti Moore forget it by John and she started the umpire. She said, you see, he, if I ever get out there on that field, it's me and he. But Justin Allen started to blade ball and the score started to move and everyone at Allen made the crowd cheering. Tanti Moore, nice, that's my boys and them, they go bust all the day. Next thing, brap, Schlepert out, braps, Eddie out, braps, Corey out, Imchel and Jumadin spinning ball like joke and wicket holding like smoke. The crowd cheering them too. Tanti Moore get vexed. She saw the crowd too hypocrite. How they're back in one body 1 minute and the next body next minute. Then she turned around and see how empty as stoning. So I felt like a spinner cannot stone where you come from. Well, who tell he say that? We get the whole history of St. Vincent again, except this time she stand up on the seat. I beg her, darling, please come down, share the food. Well, she opened the basket and she gave out food. Well, even the Bajon get a chicken leg, right? But just then, we let out at 96 and Roberts come in the bat. Tanti Moore says she can't see from where she is, so she's going down front. So Tanti in front, I behind. Roberts, whoop, hit a six, Gomes jump and catch him. But who tell Gomes do that? Tanti Moore says the way Gomes jump and take that catch, he only eat mountain chicken from Dominica. And she starts to carry on. But just then, we let out and Alan out and goal coming to bat, filling near the next end. 9 balls to go, 7 runs needed, 1 wicket to fall. Noise in the oval. Boy, we hear noise. 9 balls, 7 months ago, noise in the place. 8 balls, 7 months, Tanti waving the basket. 7 balls, 7 months, Tanti waving the parasol. 5 balls, 5 runs, Tanti on top of the seat. 4 balls, 4 runs, Tanti fall off the seat. 3 balls, 3 runs, police caution Tanti. 2 balls, 3 runs, I can't even see Tanti. 1 ball, 3 runs, the man climb over the fence, Tanti climb over the fence, run on the field. Next thing, the man hit the ball, run on the pitch, score 2 runs, the same match tie, Ireland. Win. Well, boy, who'll tell them say that? Next thing I see Tanti Moore in the middle of the field. We wanted to ask people from the small island and all of them jumping up. And all you can see the pink parasol up and down, up and down. Next thing I'll speak, I say, Machine Tie, draw. So the guy, Anna, who win? Well, who tell them say that? Tanti Moore nearly caused riot. She said they're thief. She said they don't like small island people. She said tie and draw, same damn thing. She said forming delegation to go and see the Prime Minister. And she climb up on the thing that roll the pitch with. That same Tanti Moore, you say butter can't melt in your mouth. That same Tanti Moore take me 4 hours to get out of the oval. The basket mash up. We lose the parasol. And she talk from Port of Spain right up to Quebec. And when we reach the gap, you know a woman have the heart to ask me, when next we going back? Tanti at the oval. Once long ago, not so long ago, and the story I'm telling is true. a man take a pan and with a hammer in his hand, cool so, he invented something new. It was an ordinary drum in which the oil used to come. It didn't make no particular sound. One note, maybe two. You could beat it till you blew. That was all it could do for you. Then this man get the plan with a hammer in his hand and he say, you know, I think I understand. Because if the drum making one and the drum making two, well then the drum could well make quite a few. So the man take the pan with the hammer in his hand and he stoop down there on the ground. And he hit it and he beat it and he stretch it and he mark it and the pan start to make a new sound. Ting, 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 ting. Hey, was a do-re-mi and a mi-re-do was all he could make it play. But it sung so sweet, he take it in the street. And that was the first time they hear pan play. And all the way go when the crowd get around and they jump to the notes of the pong. And none will forget for the dance and the fet on the day that the steel band was born. And since that time, all over the land, you could hear the sweet sound of pan. For they hit it, and they beat it, and they stretch it, and they mark it like the man with the hammer in his hand. They make a tenor pan, and they make a second pan. Then they come and make a double tenor too. Then they make a guitar pan, and they make a cello pan. Now, it's taking 100 men to make a band. They're playing do-re-mi and fa sol la ti do, any place the pan can go. Upper class, middle class, lower class, new class. Classics to calypso. It was born on the streets of Trinidad. It has now gone far and wide. And there ain't no stopping, and there ain't no staying. It's the sound of a people's pride. So when you hear the beat of that steel band in the street and the shuffle of 1,000 feet, remember that man with that hammer in his hand who put the first notes on a pan. How he hit it and beat it and he stretch it and he mark it as he stooped down there on that ground. How he hit it and beat it and he stretch it and he mark it and the pan start to make that new sound. Ting, 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 ting. And that's how the steel band was born. You know, people say, Paul Keynes, all these years you going up and down the Caribbean doing storytelling. What is the biggest challenge we have in the Caribbean? I say, boy, our biggest challenge in the Caribbean is communication. Sometimes we just don't understand each other. Just think about the different accents. You have Grenadian, Vincentian, Dominican, Trinidadian, Tobagonian, Caymanian accent, Bahamian accent, you have San Fernando accent, Port of Spain accent, you have Dongtong accent, you have Uptong accent, you have accent by accident. So you understand the kind of problem you have with accents? For instance, Grenadians say prefer, Vincentians say prefer. Arguing prefer, 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 a Trinidadian person. He said, Trini, come tell us, man, what is the word prefer or prefer? He said, boy, personally, I prefer prefer. You understand the problem here? And the word is even worse. Vincentian say either. St. Lucian say either. Arguing either, 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 either. A Bajan passing. Well, you know, Bajans think they talk the best. You know, Bajans is the only people in the Caribbean never lose the accent. Bajan that's born with the accent, that's dead with the accent. Trinidadian, he fly over country accent, change as he passing, right? But Bajans don't lose the accent, so they're arguing either, 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 either. The Bajan passing. They say, Baj, come on, tell us what is the word either. Or either hear the Bajan, oida man, oida, 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 oida. So you see, as you go up the road, communication is key. You know, we rarely, sometimes what we say is not what we are saying. Other day I working in Cascade, a woman running behind the garbage truck, tell her, man, you have room for more garbage? So I say, yes, man, jump in, jump in, jump in, jump in. Tell you more next time.